The Maha suspense continues. We're talking about Maharashtra. Sharad Pawar, the NCP chief, did meet Sonia Gandhi for an hour this evening. But at the end of that, no major statement on the road ahead for the Congress, the NCP and the Shiv Sena to come together in forming an alliance to come to power in Maharashtra. Mr. Pawar said they didn't even discuss government formation with the Shiv Sena. Is this to keep the Sena on the edge, keep the situation on the boil, or is this alliance less likely than we thought it would be?
किसी के साथ जाना या न जाना इस इश्यू के बारे में हमने अभी इस पर बात ही की नहीं. इफ कांग्रेस और एनसीपी हैज टू टेक अ व्यू, दे हैव टू डिस्कस विद इन देमसेल्फ फर्स्ट. कॉमन मिनिमम प्रोग्राम हमने तय करने की बात की नहीं.
अगर बातचीत आगे बढ़ी है ऐसा आपको लगता है तो जल्दी आपको पता चलेगा. अभी मैं पवार साहब को इसलिए मिला हूँ, महाराष्ट्र में जो स्थिति है किसानों की, जो बारिश है, जो हालत है वो बहुत ही गंभीर है, किसानों का बहुत नुकसान है.
ऑलराइट, वेल लेट्स क्विकली गेट अ कपल ऑफ रिएक्शंस एट दिस स्टेज. वी आर नाउ जॉइंड बाय संजय झा ऑफ द कांग्रेस पार्टी. संजय, आर वी एनी क्लोजर टू फिगरिंग आउट व्हाट्स हैपनिंग बिटवीन मिसेस गांधी एंड शरद पवार? Because it's all a big mystery. Or is this the game that you're playing to keep the Shiv Sena on edge?
Vishnu, I think the very fact that Mr. Pawar is there to meet the Congress President, Mrs. Gandhi, I think is a manifestation of the political intent to work on giving Maharashtra a government. I live here and I can tell you Maharashtra has some very serious issues to confront and address at the earliest. And therefore, you know, any further delay in forming a government is not something that I think the people out here will take very kindly to. So I'm very sure that, you know, there is an effort to try and make things happen. The nitty-gritties always take a little time. But once again, it is a new experiment, a new coalition arrangement. So I think some of the what a lot of people see as a hiccup is actually quite practical and understandable.
Is the Congress interested in being a part of the government, or is it wanting to support this potential alliance from outside?
You know, Vishnu, ever since the BJP-Shiv Sena alliance broke and the only alternative to ensuring that there will not be a fresh election in Maharashtra or a continued president's rule is that three parties will have to come together because there is no other fourth party or the independents don't have enough numbers. So the fact is that end of day, you know, whether you want to be part of the government or be outside of it, the key factor is, will it be stable? And that's exactly what I think the Shiv Sena
from what we understand, neither the NCP or the Shiv Sena want you outside. They don't want the Congress to be the one that pulls the chair from under the government, as it were. They want you to be participative and they want you to be part of an alliance government. Why do you not want to do that? Is the baggage of your own background, ideology, the fact that it's very different from the Shiv Sena, is that what's holding you back?
You know, Vishnu, I think the real issue here is about the fact that governance should be of a very exemplary standard. The Congress does have a lot of talent where that is concerned. You know, we have been in government for a long time.
So then why aren't you wanting to be part of the government?
Well, you know, just to answer your question, I mean, if it is to be unstable just because you're outside, you can be in government and decide to pull out as well.
So Sanjay, you're more or less telling me that where the Congress presently stands is outside, right? That you will support this this formation, but from the outside.
No, I think there is a divided view on that within the party. You have heard a lot of leaders, I think, on NDTV, I heard a lot of our leaders from Maharashtra who had to momentarily shift to Jaipur, say they wanted to be part of the government.
Precisely.
I think it's very natural.
So is it
ambition.
Your top leadership, is it Mrs. Gandhi versus, not versus, but her view being different from, you know, a lot of your party workers on the ground who from day one have said, look, if we have this unexpected shot at forming the government, then let us form it.
Well, the fact is that as we talk today, in fact, Mr. Pawar has also been extremely explicit. The Congress and the NCP...
He's not been explicit. I think that's the problem. Mr. Pawar is a master player. I mean, he is the consummate Indian politician. What he says and what he doesn't say, we can analyze in 10 different ways.
Well, what
he's
he
not been explicit. I think he's been explicit in being vague.
But let me answer what I was going to say. He's been explicit in saying, and I repeat that again, he's been explicit in saying that the Congress and NCP fought this election together and will take a collective call in terms of the nature of the new formation.
Okay.
When it will be formed, hopefully very soon. In Maharashtra, I can tell you, people are very sanguine, highly optimistic, because they do realize that there is the BJP is anyway out of the equation. And the only alternative available
we'll
for
we'll
a
ask the BJP if they're out of the equation as well. But Sanjay, you're welcome to stay on in this debate. But for some reason, the Congress party wants to do these one-on-one interviews. Very surprising. Not wanting to be part of the process. How un-Congress-like. Anyhow, thanks very much for being with us. Stay on if you like. G. Radhakrishnan, Shiv Sena leader and spokesperson, joins us now. Seema Malik of the NCP, Smita Gupta, Deshratan Nigam, and Niranjan Shetty. Join us as well. Mr. Shetty, let me come across to you. Is it game over as far as the BJP is concerned, as a lot of people believe it is? Or do you think the fact that the Congress, NCP and Shiv Sena are taking so much time essentially means that you still have a chance if you're able to convince the Shiv Sena to come on board once again?
I think the political scenario that has been seen right from the morning, since this NCP chief supremo came to Delhi, and the way he reacted to the questions of the journalists, I think that itself proves what's actually brewing inside his mind and basically what's going on. So I don't think that we should lose any hope, any kind of hope. Yes, we have given our say on this thing. Now the choice is up to them. Now they have been accusing us that they were not given some kind of time limit, 24 hours including that and all. Now so many days have passed, and now you must have yourself heard that the latest press conference that he spoke about, he said that there are almost 6 months more to form the government.
Are you optimistic, Mr. Shetty, in reaching out to the Shiv Sena once again?
In politics, what I think channels... everyone is optimistic. I don't think that...
No, I know that. I agree. But quite frankly, what are your channels now with the Shiv Sena? They've backstabbed you once. Are you already in a position to have back-channel talks? We are told these talks may be happening through some leaders or some influential individuals. All sorts of things are being heard. So can you confirm that you're talking to them?
Vishnu, I think let the Shiv Sena conclude its talks with all the probabilities and, try out all these probabilities. And once they are done, then we are there.
Okay. Seema Malik, among other things which was quite interesting, was the Prime Minister actually praising the NCP in Parliament today, saying that, you are a party that has never rushed the well of the House, you are the BJD. Given the situation that... You have sort of taken away their key ally. It was quite unexpected, I think.
No, I don't think so.
Was this a gentle and a very diplomatic, a very tactful move by the Prime Minister to sort of signal to Mr. Pawar look, Mr. Pawar, you may be talking to Sonia Gandhi, but we are here as well?
See, Prime Minister, generally he speaks high about Sharad Pawar ji, generally what I have seen in past also. And I think this question you should ask with the BJP person then, because we don't know why they pray.
As somebody who tracks the BJP closely, do you believe? I'm sure you would find that statement by the Prime Minister interesting. In politics and with Narendra Modi, nothing is coincidental. It is always done with a purpose. I think we both agree that is the case.
It is becoming interesting every day and every hour and every minute. And especially when Sharad Pawar ji says, we have not talked to Sena about formation of the government, and says "Acha," and that "Acha" was in double inverted commas, and that is where the art of diplomacy in politics comes into the picture. Those subtle hints have been given, and let me tell you,
there was a collective groan from about 100 journalists when they heard that "Acha."
Yes.
Because the story is not ending anytime soon, and
that became the headlines.
Yes.
And
it will be the headline
yes.
tomorrow.
And
Smita is dying to.
No,
to,
let me also finish. And the fact remains that if you read European political scientists, you will not be able to decipher what is happening in India. But if you have read Chanakya, you would be.
We are listening to Chanakya over here.
So once anybody who has read Chanakya and the concept of Samdam Dand Bhed and something beyond is Mr. Modi.
Right.
Let me tell you.
All right. Okay. Smita, where do you see this going? Because a lot of people would say that the longer it takes the Congress, which is typically slow, to figure out this alliance, you could end up, the Congress could end up shooting itself on its own foot. This is a godsend opportunity to come to power, directly, indirectly, whichever way you want to. But they seem to be taking their time and indecisiveness again.
Well, I think the Congress is concerned about its image as a secular party. And therefore, I think until they have that common minimum program all signed and sealed, I don't think they're going
and
to...
And they're nowhere close to that.
And they're nowhere close
They've
to that.
They've not even spoken about
yeah.
it.
Even if they have it.
But they don't. They've not spoken about it.
Assuming if they have it, it will be a very rough ride. Because there will be issues where there will be clear divergent opinions between the coalition partners.
G. Radhakrishnan, come in over here.
No, I don't agree with that. You know, I feel that, you know, the Shiv Sena also, the current Shiv Sena is not the old Shiv Sena. If you see their new leader, Aditya Thackeray, he is presenting himself as a moderate. Yes. It rarely happens yes. in a right-wing party that it moves to the
Go ahead, Mr. Radhakrishnan, respond to that. There is only one Shiv Sena of Hindu Samrat Balasaheb Thackeray right from the beginning. There is no change in our ideology. There is no change in our working system. Senadipati Sri Uddhavji Thackeray is taking all decisions. We have actually informed the public, general public of Maharashtra, that government has to be in its place. That is our ultimate aim. And we spoke, other parties, they spoke themselves. Sharad Pawar ji, he went to Delhi, met Sonia ji. And they couldn't arrive a conclusion. He didn't tell anything negative today.
So where does that leave you, Mr.
Radhakrishnan? Discussions are going on. Sri Ramdas Athavaleji, he is telling something else. He is telling he met
Mr. Radhakrishnan, let me tell you what Mr. Sharad Pawar said. And you tell me where that leaves the Shiv Sena this evening. He said, discuss the Maharashtra deadlock, didn't discuss government formation. Then what was he discussing for 1 hour? Who knows? He said, no coordination panel meeting has taken place. Says, can't say if the BJP Shiv Sena will come back again. Cannot say. What is that supposed to mean? He said, didn't get into a discussion on government formation with the Congress. Want to talk to all parties who supported us. So this is actually saying nothing. Does this make you very nervous, Mr. Radhakrishnan, as a political party today?
Never. Because we are not deterred by any such political developments. Shiv Sena is to serve the people. So that is all rhetoric. All these four major parties.
But you have broken away from your closest ally, the BJP. Right? You have broken away
it's
with them with the expectation that
we
you will come to power with a chief minister in alliance
that.
With the NCP who you thought would figure out an alliance with the Congress. Now Sharad Pawar meets Sonia Gandhi, comes out and says absolutely nothing. Where does that leave you?
So it doesn't affect us at all. See, because no single party can form government in Maharashtra. That is the situation. Somebody should join with other. Either BJP Shiv Sena or NCP Congress Shiv Sena, something should join to some
okay.
something
Smita,
should happen.
Point,
otherwise, nothing will happen. We will go on talking. So we are very sure. We are very very.
Yeah,
I ensure that
Uddhav Thackeray cancelling his visit to Ayodhya
in Maharashtra.
Uddhav Thackeray cancelling his visit to Ayodhya.
Is that a signal?
Why did he do that?
No, we are not deviating from our Hindutva. See, so many things are there. Programs may get changed. That's normal in political. Our ideology with Ayodhya, it never changed. There is a very clear court order, and we are now happy.
Okay, so now it really boils down to Mr. Pawar and the NCP at this stage.
See, you seem to have all the strings. Information is a serious matter, I think. It needs a lot of this thing, discussions and consensus and all those things. And speculating certain things
in the opposition. Is the NCP happy sitting in the opposition? You won't say that, will you?
No, why not? Why not? We very clearly said that we will sit in the opposition.
So you're okay with that?
just because of this president's rule and all this, we know nobody wants an election again in the this thing, you know, in Maharashtra.
So in a scenario
and for the
like
benefit
that,
of the people of Maharashtra, whatever we'll do for the benefit of the people of Maharashtra.
There is another
only,
right.
And nothing else, you know. So
you look forward to the Congress sorting out its issues. You are ready to go with the Shiv Sena.
I
am
no one to comment at present.
Of course
actually,
you are.
It is too early it is too early to comment actually on this matter. It is too early.
I don't think any spokesperson will venture.
No.
Are you?
It is too early to speculate all these things, you know. And what have
so what is the timeline within which you believe that the Congress party needs to get its act together?
Maybe in a few days it will become clear.
How vulnerable do you believe the Congress's MLAs are? The more time you take.
That you ask from the Congress people only.
No, I'm asking you. They will say they're not vulnerable, they're invulnerable.
No, so that you ask.
Smita, would you like to take that? The longer this goes, and given the fact that you've had them hoarded into a hotel in right, in Rajasthan, in Jaipur.
Yeah.
Now they're back. They want to come to power. They're being denied, at least for the moment. Is the BJP not looking at this as a potential opportunity?
The BJP would definitely like to get back. But the point is that has the BJP burnt its votes with the Shiv Sena and vice versa? Because otherwise, the BJP is unlikely to find a partner either in the NCP or in the Congress.
Okay. All right. Last question to Niranjan Chetty, sir. What is...
The only thing that can happen is if they buy up. I mean, and if people are willing to be bought up. Yeah.
Mr. Chetty, what is the BJP's playbook? What is the BJP's playbook now going forward? Do you have anything to do? Or you just wait and watch? I mean, has the BJP given up hope unless there's a fresh election or whatever?
Vishnu, I think, Vishnu, what I would like to just, Mr. Radhakrishnan, who is considered to be a leader of the Shiv Sena, and who is speaking not from Maharashtra, but from the southern part of the India, I would like to tell him that in 2009, when Congress and NCP fought together, it was the NCP who had got the more seats. But in spite of that, they settled to the Deputy Chief Minister or the Home. Basically, you know, they should understand that what the behind whom they are going, you know. Basically, what they did not ever fight with the Congress, in spite of they winning the more seats than the Congress. So, I think he should tell his leader to understand, you know, all these probabilities and come to the table and, you know, instead of going from the natural alliance. Basically, that's what I can tell him.
I agree that we are the Shiv Sena and BJP are natural allies.
Really?
But we miserably failed to form the government and we failed to form the
are
government.
Are you still
together.
A natural ally?
So it's, I or, don't blame.
Or is that all in the past so, tense now? Are you still
yes,
a natural ally?
Right from 1984, we allied together. We were in
are you now, today, still a natural ally or that alliance is
1995,
gone?
1995, we formed a government. No, I cannot say that the alliance is gone. We have not broken. See, the situation is that Shiv Sena,
Vishnu,
Shiv Sena,
that
we have resigned from the ministry.
From the
today,
Supremo.
It's not that we have not, we
not
allied
fight.
With any party. Discussions are going on.
For the chief
we respect,
in spite of
we,
the highest,
NCP chief,
more seats
we respect Congress leader. Nothing,
do you still respect the BJP, sir?
With each other.
Mr. Radhakrishnan, do you still respect the BJP?
Definitely. Udhavji Thackeray never told anything against Sri Narendra Modi ji or Amit Shah ji. And no Shiv Sainik will talk ill of BJP or any other party.
All right. Well, if now. You've got respect for all parties, including the BJP, who you sort of left high and dry, and if the NCP still doesn't know where they're going, the Congress openly says that their leaders on the ground have a different idea than possibly their leaders at the center, and the BJP says they're just waiting and watching. I mean, Niranjan Chetty didn't really say that, but I think that's what he means. Then where does that leave the millions of people in Maharashtra? And I think the answer as of now is nowhere. But what's this political space? It will develop one way or the other. We'll take a short break. More coming up.